Hello guys, so in this video I'm gonna show you how we can create an app that can listen a notification and that will save all notification in one app. Okay, this app can be used for anything that can save your WhatsApp notification, that can save your important notification, that can save anything in your app. Okay, so let me show you how we can use it and how we can create this app. So first of all, let's create a new project and my project name is notification app. So as you can see here, that's the first screen. So in the left side, you'll find the one button. Just try and drop this and let's click on that width is 70% like this. Change the text to just submit like start service. Okay. And change that background color to the pink or something or green. Okay. And make this text is white. Let me make this the dark green, okay, like this, and I'll just make this font size to the 18 and click on the screen and make this in a center, horizontal, vertical. Now same, just copy and paste this button and another button name, background color is the pink and the text color is the black and the text should be fetch. Okay, fetch all notification done. Now in the left side you will find the list view, just drag and drop this, and I need one label to display the current notification. Okay, like this. Then so that's the overall app design. Now in the left side you will find here the extension, click on this. Now we need to download one extension, so I will give you that link of this extension. This extension name is notification listener and that extension will work on the app background. It means whenever you close your app, still this app or your app will work. Okay, so just scroll down and you find the AIX file. Just click on this, download this and go to the app inventor again, click on the import extension, click on choose file this and import it. Now just drag and drop this here like this. Now let's go to the block. So once you click on button one, that service will start. Okay, so when button one dot click, then extension, as you can see, a start service. Then now once we click on the button two, this will fetch all notification. Okay, so list view, and as you can see here, the set element list view, and we need to fetch the all. Okay, so what we need to do here, we need to get the all notification, but where is the notifications? Okay, so we have only one notification in the label. Now we need to save that notification in some cloud DB or the tiny DB. So I will save that in the local. Okay, so click on the storage, as you can see the tiny DB, this one, just drag and drop this like this. Let's go to the block. Okay, and click on tiny DB and you will find the get entries. Just get this. Now we have to save the data in the tiny DB also. How we can do this? So once we click on the button, so suppose whenever we click on any button, or whenever we click on the, or whenever we receive the notification. Okay, so click on the typhoon, this one. As you can see here, when we receive the notification, so first we'll display that notification in the label. Okay, so as you can see, this is the label, label one dot text, this one, just this. And once the notification we receive, we'll display that notification in JSON format in the level one. But at the same time, we have to save that notification also. So click on tiny DB, store value, and tag you can make it a random. So I'll use here two integer values like this. And the integer will start from one and it goes up to 10 digits, so it can be definitely a random. And value we need to store is JSON, this one, done. And then at the same time, that notification will save in the tiny DB also. Okay, tag and value, and once we click on the button two, so that will fetch the all entries of tiny DB. That's it. So that's the overall app that we have created. Okay, whenever you receive some notification, suppose it can be a WhatsApp notification, it can be a USB charger notification, any notification, and that will save in your app.
And yes, that app will work on the background also. Okay, so let me show you how this will work. Okay, first, so let's first we need to start this. So let's click on this button. This will redirect to here, notify service, allow this, go back. Now service is started. Okay, now let me just remove, as you can see here in the top, my phone is charging here. Let me just remove that USB cable, and as you can see, there is a notification. And as you can see here, once you receive the notification, you will find that notification is here. Android system, low battery, text, please charge the phone quickly. This is the notification that I have received here. As you can see here, see this one. So that notification is here. Okay, so as you can see, there is one button. So click on this button. And as you can see, here's all notification.
So if you have any doubt, you can ask me in a comment. Please subscribe my channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye-bye.